Hey, Chris Menard here. I've got a great Copilot in Excel video for you. I'm going to share this Excel file. This is going to cover two major items for you. Copilot, I love it, but it's fairly new. Copilot in Excel, compared to Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, or the other apps, it has got to be exact. What I mean by that is if you ask Copilot to only show you customers with revenue over $1,000, that is a filter, and it better give you the correct results. So I'm going to run through multiple tests today. I'm going to cover everything from sorting, filtering, charts, pivot tables, and just asking questions. You can use this file for two things. If you've never used Copilot in Excel, you can do exactly the same test that I'm going to do. And what I'm hoping to make sure is that we're getting the exact answers. So I'm also not only going to let you see Copilot in action, we're going to test and make sure the results are correct. After you do that, you can then, if you've never used Copilot, start using this with your data, but you'll see how to test your data instead of using this Excel file that I'm giving you. Let's go ahead and look at the tests we're going to do. There are chapters and bookmarks throughout here. I'll make sure you realize where we're at. If you just want to jump around, you can. There are two worksheets. I went to the test worksheet, a little promotion here, my website's listed, and B1, B2 has got my Copilot training course, and B3 has got all my online training courses. But here we go. Here are the tests that we're going to run using this file. As you can see, we've got everything from sorting, filtering, highlighting data, which is conditional formatting, asking questions, pivot tables, pivot charts. Let's go ahead and get started right now. So I put this as a test because you have to do this. Step one is to make sure everything is set up correctly. So when I click over on the customer's worksheet, click inside your data, the three requirements are make sure it is saved to OneDrive, and it is. Step two is make sure auto save is turned on, and it is. And step three, when you click in your data, it can't be a range, it has to be a table, and it reads table design up here at the top. You can change the style if you want to. Those are the three requirements to use Copilot in Excel. I click back on the home tab. So here comes the first test. I want to sort by one column. I'm going to go back to customers. I'm on the home tab, and here is Copilot. There are some prompts. You don't have to use them, but if you wanted to click on sort and filter, you can. Go ahead and click on it. I'm going to click on it. It's just giving you some suggestions, but I do want to do a sort. I'm going to say sort by state A to Z order. Press enter or click on the arrow to the right for send. Look at state in column E. It is understanding the data first. Interesting, I did not have filters turned on. It turned on filters for me because I have a table. Look at state, you can see that the arrow is pointing up. That is ascending order right there. To check this, you could right click any state, go to sort, and do a sort A to Z is how you would check to make sure this one's right. This one's easy, you can just look up there and see that it's correct because it turned the filters on. Let's keep going. The next test is I want to sort by multiple columns. I'll do this twice. I'm going to say sort by state, then by city, because notice my cities are not sorted, just my states are. What's interesting about this one? Two things. One, I'm going to misspell the word orders intentionally. But the second item is when I did my first sort, I told it to sort A to Z. This one, I'm going to say sort in ascending order. I got state first and then city. I'll hit send. Perfect. This is exactly right. Look at the two filters in D1 and E1. The arrows are both pointing up. Look at the data, though. I've got California before Georgia. If you look in California, I've got San Diego listed before San Francisco. If you wanted to test that manually, even though you can look here and tell it's correct, that would be data sort. And look, data sort is actually reflecting what Copilot did. How cool is that? So there is that test passed. I'm actually Test number three, I'm going to run again. Here's why. I know it's working correctly with multiple columns, but I kept picking on text columns. Let's just do something numeric and something with text. And I'm going to change this completely. I'm going to say sort by, let's pick something besides state. Sort by source ascending, then by FY24, column I, from highest to lowest. That's how I would probably say this. Fingers are crossed. Let's take a look and see if it got it right. And it did. Source, the arrow is pointing up. FY24, the arrow is pointing down. I have Google Ads before LinkedIn. Look at the Google Ads. That is correct. And then I hit LinkedIn, so the number goes up again. Perfect. So I'm saying the sorting test passed for Copilot right there. Test number four, let's go look at filtering data. Click in here. What I love about Copilot is you just type in the prompt box what you would normally be saying to someone. Show only the state of GA. We should have, if it works correctly, we should end up with some rows in blue because it should be doing a filter for us. And that is correct. Look at cell E1. There is the funnel. Click on it and just Georgia is selected. To test that, if you didn't know how to, you would go to the data tab, hit filter, hit the drop down, pick GA and hit OK. But it did it for us and it is correct. Let's see if it'll do a multiple filter. Now, I could type the word filter, but let's do show only. I want to pick on some date fields, and there's invoice date. Show only GA and invoice date after. All those dates are for the year 2024, so let's say after 7/1/24. Let's go test it. Only Georgia is correct. Invoice date, date filters, after. I clicked it and look what's in here. 7/1/24. Perfect. This is correct right here. So all good so far. That was a filter by multiple columns and we did a couple. Let's go do some conditional formatting. This will be test number six. I am going to clear the filter myself. Let's see if it'll do that for us, by the way. I didn't think about that one. Clear all filters. And it did. All right. I threw that one in there. Done. I removed all filters on the table one. Okay. Sure. Okay. We want to do some conditional formatting. This is highlighting. I'm going to first pick on something numeric. I'm going to look at FY24. Highlight numbers over 900 for FY24 in a green background color. So I'm not filtering because I would only tell it to show only or filter. I'm telling it just to highlight so I should see all the data. And there it worked. This is conditional formatting. Let's prove it. If you didn't know how to use conditional formatting, you would highlight this range, all the numbers. You would go to the Home tab. You would click Conditional Formatting. You would select Highlight Sales Rules Greater Than. But it's already done it for us. So in this test, you would come down to Manage Rules. And it's telling me inside of this table, I've got cell values greater than 900 in this color here. You could edit the rule from here. And I could change this to another fill color if I wanted to, but I'm not going to. It is working correctly. Perfect. Let's do another one because in real life, you can have multiple conditional formattings on multiple columns. Let's pick on the state column again. Instead of doing a background color, let's do a font color. Put the state of Georgia in a red font color. You can pick whatever color you want. It should leave the green in FY24 running. It says it's done. I'm looking over there. Perfect. Same steps as before because I want to make sure you know how to test this. When we go to conditional formatting, under manage rules, there should be two. There we go. GA, red color, E2 to E36. How cool is this? This is great stuff here. I'm going to go back to the test. I'm going to say conditional formatting was a pass. I just want to ask some questions and check some answers now. So we're on test number 7. I'm going to clear the conditional formatting. Let's see if it'll do that, though. I didn't put this one down. Clear all conditional formats. Clear all conditional formats. That sounds good. Perfect. To test it, you would go to conditional formatting, manage rules, and we don't have any rules. So that is a pass also. So now, I can't recall what I said we're going to do. So let me go back and look. We're going to ask some questions and check some answers. Another reason that I love Copilot in Excel is just to ask these questions. So let's say someone's hardly used Excel. First of all the stuff we've done has been cool, but let's go and test this just asking questions. How many customers have, how many for FY23, how many numbers over 1,000? I don't want to filter. I don't want to sort. I'm just asking a question. I want an answer that I can tell someone on my team. I'm hoping I get an answer back here. It's telling me there's 9. To test this, you would just hit, since you know how to do this now, you would click here, number filters, what did I say, over, greater than 1,000. Number filters, greater than 1,000. I could have filtered this too, though. And there you go, right there. If you highlight these numbers, the count is 9, and the numerical count is 9. Perfect. I'm going to just clear this one, just since we're knowing how to use this now. Let's ask one more question. So this question, I want the answer, but it's going to be 2 fields. For GA, what is the total FY24? What is the total for FY24 is how I would ask that. So I'm not asking for every state. I want to know one state, what's the total for GA FY24. It's coming back with 17,571. I could add that to a new sheet, but here's an easy way to test it. I'm just going to sort by state. Here's GA. I could filter this, by the way. I'm going to highlight all the GAs. Look down in your status bar. The sum is 17,521. By the way, I got to give you a bonus tip here. If I left click 17,571, click somewhere and do Control V or paste, it will paste that number and it keeps it as just the number. There's no formula there. Cool little tip there for you. I did delete that though. I'm going to say that asking questions and checking answers is a pass. Let's go do a few pivot tables and we'll be done here. Pivot tables and pivot charts. Total, here's a pivot table for you. Total FY24 for each state. We should get a pivot table and a pivot chart that we can insert into this worksheet. That is how we will test this, and we'll look at some of the numbers to make sure they're correct. It came back with a bar chart. It is finishing up, and it comes down here and tells you what it did, but I'm going to add to a new sheet. Right now, I've got 2 worksheets, customers and tests. Now we've got a sheet 1. I am going to zoom in on this a little bit. Georgia, 17,571. I believe we just checked that number. The grand total is 36,706. Let's test that number real quick. Back to customers, select column I, 36,706. And I could sit here and just do, I'm going to do one more state, California. We already got this sorted. 3,977. Back to sheet 1 at the bottom. California, 3,977. And we get this nice pivot chart in here that is a bar chart. We could change it if we want to. That is a pass. Let's do a pivot table now based on 2 fields. Technically, it's going to be 3. I'm doing state. I'm doing household type, but I want to know something numeric. I'm going to keep picking on this FY24. So let's say we want to total each state and each household type for FY24. Let's see if it knows what I'm trying to tell it to do in this one. Hope you're having a good time. I know I am. This is great, great stuff. Let's let this one finish up. This one may not have got it right. I don't know yet. Let me hit add to a new sheet. Let's zoom in. Actually, it did get it correct. I was not expecting this. It is no big deal here. It did the single, couple, and family running down the rows and the states across the column. If you click inside here one time, there's the states in the column and there's the household type. I'm going to take state. I mean, I could have let it go the way it was, by the way. I guess what I'm saying is I was expecting this right here, and it did this. No big deal because it's correct right there. So that one is a pass also. In real life, I would be renaming these worksheets if I wanted to save them. Pivot table something, pivot table something. I like to name my worksheets that have pivot tables, PT for pivot table. So there's a pass on that one, by the way. So now I just want to ask it about charts. Let's see if I can get real specific here. I'm tired of picking on states. Let's pick on household type. But let's tell it what type of chart we want. Create a pie chart for FY24 for each household. I am telling it I want a pie chart. Let's see if it can come back and figure that one out. Let's add this. It did exactly what we wanted. We could go back and sort by single, couple, or family. We could filter by it and check the numbers. These are correct. What it didn't do is show the percentages here, and I like percentages. You can click in here and on the design tab, throw some percentages in here. One more test. I'm going to add this one on the fly. Add a column. I forgot about this one. So here's test 11. Back over in my data, inside my data, I have FY24, I have FY23. I want to add a column in column K that shows the percentage difference from 23 to 24. I could show the dollar difference, but let's make it a little more difficult. Add a column is how I would start this off to let it know immediately I want a new field that shows the percentage difference from FY23 to FY24. I'm going to leave the word difference misspelled. See if we can figure that out. It's off to a good start. It is actually correct. I'm looking at the formula. They want to take the year 24, subtract the year 23, and do that first. That would be your dollar difference. Then they want to divide by the previous year, which is 23. If I mouse over insert column, it gives me a preview of it. It looks correct to me. I'm going to hit insert column. I'm going to scroll to the top and change a couple numbers. 720 times 2 is 1440. That should be a 100% difference, and it is. I'm going to do an undo. I just wanted to test a number real quick. Click on that percentage difference formula in cell K2 and look up in your formula bar. It is correct. Excellent. I appreciate your time. I know this was a long video, but there are chapters and bookmarks. Feel free to check out my online training courses. This file is going to be available for download. Have a great day. Thank you.